What's up, y'all? It's your girl Lex, and I am back with another vlog, but this time it's a special occasion. It is my 28th birthday, and of course I went back to Moon Palace. Y'all know it feels like home every time I'm here. One of my subscribers wrote on my page and told me that Méle Méle Destinations was actually having Cancun Carnival at Moon Palace. So we changed some things around to stay later for Carnival, and goodness, it was a good time. So we came, we got into our private vehicle because we are members, and those are my Virgo nails because, of course, our room wasn't ready when we got there, but actually, he surprised me with a honeymoon suite. So the honeymoon suite supposedly comes with all these different amenities. It looked exactly like the last room that we had, but with flowers. With flowers on it. So our room wasn't ready. We did go to the nail salon because as a member, you receive complimentary manicure, pedicure, and a 25-minute back massage. So I was disappointed that they don't remove gel, and I wasn't able to get my toes done, and I specifically didn't get them done because I knew I could get them done there. But it was okay. My toes luckily didn't look bad. I just got them done. So they basically just gave me a hand and foot massage to make up for it. We headed over to Los Tacos, and we were starving. I got the al pastor. I get pastor everywhere I go. Please go to Los Tacos and experience those tacos. Once we finished our lunch, our room was ready, and we got driven over on the golf cart, and to our surprise, we were in building 85 again. God bless the bellhops, because this part of 85 that we were on didn't have an elevator. You can walk down to the elevator side and then just walk across, but where our room was, it was steps. So once we made it up the steps, 3 flights to be exact, we got into the room and we were like, oh, it looks literally like our old room. So I'll tell you why he booked the honeymoon suite. He was promised 12 o'clock check-in, a bottle of champagne in the room, decor, which is the roses, chocolate-covered strawberries, and a birthday cabana for one day. Thank goodness all the calls are recorded, because when we got there, they didn't want to honor anything. And that was a slap in the face because we had like excellent service and never really had a problem with the place. But we had to fight up and down to get them to give us the chocolate covered strawberries, to give us the champagne, to give us the cabana. I didn't even get the cabana for my birthday. Like, we were still arguing them down for it. Also, the honeymoon suite came with a romantic dinner. It was a prefixed menu, and actually it just didn't sound good. So I said, no, I don't want it. I want to eat at La Chateau, where it's actually held at, but I want to eat the menu from La Chateau. They tried to say no, and then they said yes, and we actually did. You will see later in the vlog, we did eat at La Chateau, and it was actually really good. I know you're like, y'all can't still be on day one. This is the longest day ever. So it is our ritual to go get hibachi the first night of whatever hotel we're at, okay? So we went over to the Sunrise, to Momo, and we wandered around until it opened up. And I thought Agra was down this hallway, but it was just pictures. And I found out later where the actual door was. But I just wanted to enjoy this beautiful artwork down this hallway. It's finally hibachi time. We get edamame to start, and then a California roll, and then the chef starts cooking. And you get chicken, beef, or steak, or you can choose one protein, and they just give you a little bit more of that protein. And let me tell you, they have significantly cut the portion sizes, but in good faith, because usually they give too much food. This was like the perfect amount. And I can't say I didn't get hungry later, but the dessert was good. Momo was always good. And this is just a look around at the 24-hour cafe. I did decide to try a piece of the dark chocolate cake. I didn't really like it too much, but I said, you know what? It is what it is. I was just being greedy at that point. So this is the next day at breakfast at La Cantina. We ate here literally every day for breakfast. All I needed was my omelet and my dulce de leche croissant, some fresh fruit, and I was actually really good to go. So it was no need for us to walk all the way over to the Grand Buffet. On my birthday, there was a grand opening of the new karaoke bar, Cassette, and that was in our plans to go after I went and got my birthday facial and my massage, and it did not disappoint. First off, my facial was a literal nightmare. She literally dropped. She was like, oh, this is gonna burn. And then she proceeds to drop it in my eyeball. And I went into panic mode. But I did get into the spa. We enjoyed the hot tub. I went into the ice bath every single day. This is our everyday ritual. We get up, we go to the spa, and we go get a smoothie from the smoothie bar. And then we kind of find a pool to chill at. We kind of chilled at the spa too long, so we ended up having to leave straight from the spa to cassette, catch the grand opening, sing a song, and then go back and get changed for my birthday dinner. Everyone came in, grabbed a hat, grabbed a seat, and they started singing. And I can't believe they forced me to go up there and sing a song. But I sung Lady Gaga. I was so proud of myself, y'all. The video of Poker Face will never see the light of day. But I just wanted to let you guys know what I sung. And we got the first drinks in there. It was so cool and it was so nice. We got the sweet child of mine, and this is our final toast before we head off to dinner at La Cantina. To be honest, I did want to eat at Agra for my birthday. I didn't realize we needed reservations, and then I wanted to go to Caribeño, and it wasn't open on Tuesday, so I did have to settle for La Cantina. It was good, so I'm just not even going to complain there because it was real cute.
Happy birthday!
Do y'all know how many times I've gone to Mexico and have not gotten a churro? It's actually disgustingly too many times to count. I was so happy to get those churros. So we head over to the lobby bar to get the sidecar passions. And the bartender was like, let me do whatever for you. It's your birthday. I'm like, do it then, boo. Do it. This is actually pizza from La Tavola on the first night, like at the very end of the night. I just needed a quick bite of something because I was hungry. And again, this is my everyday breakfast at La Cantina. Then we jump on the golf cart. We were headed to the spa and we were like, we wanted to see the golf course. So we jumped on and got a tour of the golf course. And it also said spa on it, but we didn't know there was also a spa in the golf course. So we jumped on it with two intentions, but we ended up going back. Let me tell y'all something. If you are the first person at the spa when it opens, that hot tub is boiling hot. When I stepped in there, I said, oh my goodness. I don't know if I'm sensitive today or this hot tub is abnormally hot. It was burning hot. I jumped right back out. Well, 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 guess who got her chocolate covered strawberries? And they even threw in a charcuterie board. I wasn't even mad at that. So we actually enjoyed that. We ran over to the lobby bar, grabbed an electric lemonade, chilled at the Day Club Unique, and then went to Caribeño for dinner. And let me tell you something, Caribeño did not miss. We were sitting there like on couples retreat when they were eating the dinner, when they wanted to leave the resort. Every single thing was literally amazing. The presentation, the food. I wish this place was open every day. It was absolutely stellar. I wish I could have recorded everyone's reactions because we did not eat here the last time. And girl, they did not disappoint. Look at the food. And actually, one of our friends that came, this is his first time staying here. And he was like, oh my gosh, I'm floored. Now I see what you mean. It's something about adults only that just gives me a peace and satisfaction. I love the Day Club. I could fall asleep here on those beds out there. Everything about Unique is just cool. The vibe's cool. And the last time we came, there was a big old seafood party, but they didn't have it this time. But it was okay. I didn't really care too much. But Unique is like where you need to be at, in the spa. Baby, don't forget about the spa. While leaving the spa, around 6:30, that's when the acts start going to the restaurants. So I actually bumped into the mariachi band on the way back to my room. Now to La Chateau. I am a French classically trained chef, so this is right up my alley. I've been wanting to come here since the first time we've toured Moon Palace, and the decor, how the service is held, everything is beautifully perfect. So they give you a complimentary glass of champagne, and then you get to choose from each section. I chose the scallops, the shrimp bisque, and the steak. My steak was not cooked well, but I still ate it. Everything was good. It was just not cooked to the temperature I asked for. And he got the salt-crusted trout, and I did try a piece of his because it just was looking too good. And I always do this. I let someone else order what I really want, but I order something else too. And then this is the creme brulee. After dinner, we headed over to Noir. It was supposed to be burlesque night, but again, the last time we came, it was burlesque there. And this night, it wasn't, but we still had a good time. When we got back, the lights were out in the main lobby, but we safely made it back to our rooms. And then the next day, I finally got my cabana, and I enjoyed every second. I brought my journal out there. I journaled. I was in there by myself for about an hour and a half, and then everyone else came. We ordered food. We had a personal server, and we had quesadillas, tacos, burgers, things like that. I was not in the mood for the food, so I can't give you a good story, but everyone else loved it. After 6 hours at the pool, we ended up going to Jade for dinner. I secretly didn't want to go because this was our last day to go to Carabino, but I said, don't get, you know, stuck in your ways and not want to go somewhere different. So we went to Jade. Their sushi is good, but everything else on the menu is very subpar. It just didn't do it for me. So we enjoyed the music by the musician, and he came around to every table. I did have non-alcoholic drinks at this point. I ordered a California roll, a seafood stew because my stomach was still hurting, some edamame. The server told me these noodles were good, but it literally had mayonnaise on the top, and it just did not give what it was supposed to give. So I didn't enjoy anything else past my sushi, to be quite honest. We hit up the library bar, and I actually tried my first amaretto sour. I cannot remember the drink I had the first time I came, but the amaretto sour with the almonds on top was like strikingly delicious. I was like, oh my gosh, what have I been missing? There's a live band, and I just found out that they have snacks there. They have candied nuts and crackers and cookies, I believe the gentleman said. But now to the good part. Carnival. So I woke up late. I wasn't able to put my jewels on and do my hair all up like I wanted to, but I didn't want to miss the parade. So I slicked that hair back, pulled my stomach together because my stomach was hurting. But I said, I'm going out here. I don't care. I don't care. I met Michelle. Y'all, I met Michelle. Oh my goodness. Y'all don't understand. He is my favorite soca artist. And I walked past him in the hotel. I was like, my heart is just like a beautiful manifestation that I got to see my favorite artist. And that is somebody that it doesn't matter the mood I'm in, I will always be happy when I hear him. And look at this sabotage. I said, record me dancing. Can y'all see me dancing? Because I don't see me dancing. I see my ponytail. I'm tripping by that. I'm As someone that goes to Carnival and Juve's, I knew not to get there right when it first started because Carnival is a little all-day experience. But by lunchtime, we were like about to have heat stroke. So we went, sat down, we were soaked, got lunch, and then we went bowling later that afternoon. And just so y'all know, I won. Duh. We decided to just have dinner at the bowling alley, and I'll give it a solid 7 out of 10. And then we went to the beach concert for Michelle. Checkout day. We went to the spa in the morning, grabbed our juices, and I tried this toast with the kiwis and banana. I was skeptical, but it was actually really good. And this pizza is why we missed our private transportation and had to pay $35 on a public transportation.
Okay.
Goodbye, my friends. It was a pleasure having you here. We're gonna miss you very much. Until next time, okay?
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Thank you.
Thank you guys for watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe.